Hi, my name is Qinghua Lee. For your convenience, you can call me Lee. Today, we're going to learn with Mr. Bob Proctor about how to change a paradigm. This is I also share the way I'm learning. See, when I learn from Mr. Bob Proctor, this is basically the title. And then I use the link too, so later on I can go back to learn. Anyway, here he said, I went through how the conscious mind works, how the subconscious, and how the body is an expression of the mind. If you go through it a few times, you are going to see that's exactly what happens. Here is a picture show this bigger circle is our mind, but the mind is two part. Here is the top mind, top part is conscious mind, the bottom part is subconscious mind, and this is our body. And here he said, I want you to think of this for a moment. When you impress an idea upon your subconscious mind that alters the vibration of this instrument, it's our body. You see, our body is a molecule structure. It is a massive energy in a very high speed of vibration. We invented the words to describe our conscious awareness of our vibration, and that word is a feeling. If you ask a question, how you feel today? They say, oh, I'm feeling fine, or I don't feel good, I feel great. You never hear a person say, I'm consciously aware of being emotionally involved with a negative idea, so therefore I'm being moved into the negative vibration. But that's exactly what happens. As we start to understand this and we become aware that we are not feeling too good, we can change it. It takes a little bit of training, but you can do it. We are really in charge of how we feel. We let other people upset us, but we don't have to let other people upset us. We don't need to react to them. We can respond. We can listen to what they are saying, and then they say, well, you are entitled to your opinion, but that's not what I'm like. And we can hold our own ideas of ourselves. You see, it's important that we grasp how the mind works and that we understand the relationship of the body to the mind and the mind to the body. Now, it's our result that we want to change. Our result could be in our physical body. You maybe want to cast off a few pounds, or you may want to put on a couple pounds. You may want to have a little bit higher energy. All the energy there ever was or ever will be is 100% evenly presented in all places at the same time. Everything is energy. You will hear people say, where does he get all energy? Or where does she get all those energy? Nobody gets energy. Everybody releases energy. Desire is a triggering mechanism that lets the energy flow. Let's go back and look quick review how you got here. You have a conscious mind here. You have a conscious mind, and remember, you have a sensory factors hook up to the conscious mind. Then you have subconscious mind, and then you have your body. Now, the conscious mind has ability to choose thought. Those thoughts turn into pictures. We turn the picture over to the subconscious mind, and then the subconscious mind expresses the action. See now, what is the problem? So here, this is a picture, right? Because this is your conscious mind, you can choose. When you choose, you can accept or reject, and you can originate in your idea. Here, for the subconscious mind, must accept, cannot reject. And also remember, I'm continue reading those, I believe there's a mom here. Remember, we said the subconscious mind have no ability to reject. We said subconscious mind cannot differentiate between what's real. cool and was imagined. How did we arrive on the scene? When we arrived on the scene, we did not have any subconscious facility developed. The sensory factors weren't even developed. This is how you arrived. No conscious mind, so there is a subconscious mind is wide open. You can put anything in it. So here, there's a picture. Here, it's only subconscious mind, so everything come in. Your subconscious mind is programmed genetically. That's why we look like our relatives. It's built right into the genes at birth. Then we are programmed environmentally. Why do you think you speak the language you speak? Because you were surrounded by people that speak the language in your little life. And the language just went right into your subconscious mind. If you grew up in a home that bilingual, you learn both languages. Why do you like the food you like? It's programmed, that's right. Let's stop and think about the environment we were raised in. Here's a baby and look at it. The ideas and the thoughts and the concepts that are going around that baby are going right into the baby's subconscious mind. Now, through the repetition over and over and over again. And remember, the baby is getting all day, every day, all week, every month, every year, for almost 4 and 5 years. And the baby reached the age of four or five where they can start to think. That's a baby is programmed. The baby is programmed to think like the people it had been surrounded by. If the people that surround that baby had gone right through school, that baby will probably go up and go right through school. If the people that were surrounded that baby always living in hard times, never had any money, always in debt, that's probably how the baby is going to grow up. This is bizarre, but this is how it happens. It's how it happens for me. I was raised during the Depression. We didn't have any money there. Was always talking about no money, you should be satisfied with what you got. Well, that's not true. You should never be satisfied with what you got. You should be happy with what you have got. This satisfaction is actually a creative state. So here we have a baby that has been programmed. What happened when the baby started to think for itself? Now think of this. The paradigm controls the vibration. The vibration controls the action which produces the result. Here we go. You got a baby with a program and the conscious facility have developed. They have the ability to think. There's a power flow into them. What are they going to think? They are going to think thoughts that are in harmony with that paradigm. Will be raised to believe and go to work to earn money. Do you know that working is the very worst way to earn money? That's right. You should go to work for satisfaction, not for money. You provide a service for money. You can earn money when you're sleeping. In fact, we have programmed that way, teaching people earn money. Okay, here I know they're talking about, you know, Miss Bob Proctor, they have the, you know, you join their program, you can learn those. But I'm just honest with you, because I can't lie, right? I'm just learning mom on my own, because after he woke me up, I know I need to stay the way I am, because I have to be very in the relaxed mood and my speed to learn. So I haven't joined his program. But as you can see, even all the information he shared, I can learn. I get him like a program, you know, really like getting better and better. Think about if you really join the program, I know you will be have those jump leap. Is that what call the words? Now I try to remember. I think quantum leaps. Anyways, you know, they have all the information online. You can check so you can join. Anyway, here, let me just continue to finish this how to change paradigm, right? He said, paradigm can cause you to think. And then he mentioned that we will got the person they were being programmed in their little life genetically and environmentally. That paradigm is nothing but a multiple of habits. A habit is an idea that has been programmed into the subconscious mind over and over and over again. Now the paradigm is literally controlling the behavior. Consciously, you can think of one thing, but subconsciously, the other idea will be control you. See here, and also he mentioned some, there is a self book when you read, you say, oh yeah, I can do that, but then you don't know. So from my own experience, I do, you know, I'm like, realize, you see, every time there's a little, like two you, basically, you always argue with each other. Like one day they'll tell you, oh, like for me, when I'm learning, right? So I try to share with you guys. And then the other mind will tell me, you don't even know anything. What are you going to share? So I'm being arguing with myself, but you know, sometimes if you're not strong enough, the negative one always try to win. Anyway, but now you know, the little one inside you even hard to change because, you know, like I said, this paradigm, what we are, habit, maybe we get them either from genetically or the environmentally. So it's kind of hard to change, but you know, as long as you know, you can change it. And he said, think of this moment. I want you to imagine that you are going to accept idea right now to turn your annual income to a monthly income. That's another way I think they're teaching you, because you have to think in different ways so you can really make your annual income to the monthly income. But most people say, okay, I like that, but will you do it? Probably not, because your paradigm will stop you. Your paradigm literally controls the results. Let's think of how paradigm was formed. The paradigm was formed through repetition. The ideas being planted in your subconscious mind. Now, understand your paradigm dictated your logic. Your paradigm control how you utilize your time. Your paradigm control your perception of a situation. Your paradigm control your effectiveness. Your paradigm control the amount of money you earn. If you want to change your life, you must change your paradigm. Do you see? To most people, it's illogical that they could take and turn their annual income to a monthly income. But if you follow our teaching, we will show you exactly how to do that. Like I told you guys, because basically, you know, you can go to the project, I think the PIG, on their website, they'll be teaching those. But for me, I told you guys, whatever I learned, I mentioned in late July 2020, I was hooked with Mr. Bob Proctor's, you know, wisdoms. So after that, I just started learning until early October 2020, I discovered, I should use the right words, but that's what he teach. You discovered your life purpose. But from since then, I feel like I'm so grateful. So even though I could become to advisor to share, but I, like I said, I have my life purpose, so I want to focus on that. But at the same time, I'm thankful because Ms. Bob Parker woke me up. So I'm going to share the message and try to wake you up. Because to be honest with you, not all of us, maybe I think about 3% people really know this. And from my own experience, I learned it's not that easy because, you know, maybe your families, your friends, they don't even believe that, they think you're crazy. But now you understand it is true. We are spirit beings living in the physical body, gifted with intellect. But our paradigm really controlling us. If you want to change, you have to change your paradigm, which is all the multiple, it's just multiple habits. You know, it's like we either genetically or environmentally programmed, but you have to rewrite those program in order to get results. If you like my message, please share. Of course, we thank Ms. Bob Proctor for waking me up, but I'm continue learn and continue share with you. And let's all be aware the change, you know, the paradigm formed through the repetition, right? You can change it through repetition. That's why he suggests you write your goal card, repeat, reading, reading, repeat. Because when you repeat, you press all those to your subconscious mind. Remember, the subconscious mind don't know you is real or imagined. That's why you would rather build beautiful picture to press on, right? But most of us, because we're being programmed, kind of always thinking about what we don't want, we always worry. So now you know, you have to think of what you want and press to the subconscious mind, because it will become to real, because it's going to press to your body and someday become to true. So stop with worry and doubt, study and build a beautiful picture. Someday it all becomes true. Talk to you guys soon.